George Remond is an important defence contractor.
In addition to his defence work, George Remond has also made the occasional foray into the civilian sector and is about to launch onto the market this, a voice-activated telephone. Now, with me here is Dr. Miriam Benchley, the Civil Research Director of Remond Electronics, and she's kindly agreed to allow me to test this. Now, Miriam, I understand that the telephone has been programmed to respond solely to my voice, and that all I have to do is to speak into here, one digit at a time, the number I wish to dial, and it will do the rest. Is that right?
That's right, David, yes.
All right, then. One.
Repeat, please.
What happens now, Miriam?
You have to repeat the number. It didn't quite get it.
Oh, I see. Right. One.
Repeat, please.
And again.
One.
Five.
No, one.
5, 8.
It seems to be dialing the wrong number. What should I do?
Say error.
Right. Error.
5, 8, 4, 0.
No, error.
5, 8, 4, 0, 7.
Error.
5, 8, 4, 0, 7, 3, 5. Wait, please. I will get you your number.
No, that's not it. Miriam?
Keep saying error.
Right. Error. Error. Error.
Hello?
Error.
What?
Yes, I'm sorry. You're not the person I wish to speak to. The telephone didn't hear me properly.
If you don't stop doing this, I'll call the police.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Obviously, it's not quite perfect yet.
No.
There are still one or two minor problems we have to iron out.
Well, it seems to me that they're more than just one or two.
Repeat, please.
Not you. Error.
Five.
No, stop.
5, 8. 5, 8, 4, 0.
Keep saying error.
Yes, but that doesn't really work, does
five,
it?
5, 8,
it's,
4,
it's,
0,
start
seven.
It again.
5, 8, 4, 0, 7, 3, 5.
Error.
Wait, please. Mm-hmm. I will get you your
error.
Number.
Error.
Go away!
Conservative estimates put the cost so far to the British taxpayer of developing the Sea Demon system at well over £750 million.
When I was working on it, the costs were ballooning all the time. An enormous amount of money went on the chairs, for example.
The chairs?
Yeah, the chairs for the radar operators to sit on. I mean, they cost something like £15,000 each. And this was because it was decided that they should be able to withstand a nuclear blast.
Was this part of the Ministry specification?
No. I just think someone in the chair department got carried away.
Sea Demon incorporates a great deal of new technology, and that's expensive.
It's already gone four times over its original budget.
Much of the new technology incorporated is so new that we had no idea how expensive it would be. In those circumstances, the only thing we could do was to spend the money to find out.
Yes, but Minister, £750 million is a lot of money to spend on a system that doesn't work.
No. As a matter of fact, in defence terms, £750 million is not a lot of money to spend on a system that doesn't work. I know of a large number of systems that don't work that have cost many times that amount.
Yes, Minister.
In fact, if we're talking about systems that don't work, Sea Demon is easily one of the cheapest. Anyway, it will work. Soon.
Well, I hope so, otherwise a great deal of money would have been wasted.
Money spent on defence is never wasted. Even when developing a system that doesn't work, our scientists often make valuable new discoveries.
Like how much it cost?
Yes, and other things. And, of course, there is always the possibility of spin-offs in the commercial sector.
Well, in the case of Sea Demon, perhaps one of these will be a chair which is capable of withstanding a nuclear blast.
Why not? Of course, I sincerely hope that there will not ever be a nuclear war, but if there is, some people will almost certainly survive it, and those people are going to need somewhere to sit.
Whilst one department at Remond's was spending vast amounts of money developing nuclear blast-proof chairs, we've discovered that another was spending astronomical sums on trying to get the missile propulsion system to work. This Ministry of Defence film, found by a member of the public in a telephone box in Croydon, shows a test firing of the Sea Demon missile. Soon after that film was taken, costs on the Sea Demon project escalated dramatically when this Royal Navy frigate, HMS Bracknell, was employed in the tests. It has not been seen since.
Remond Electronics requested the use of a Royal Navy frigate to complete a series of tests with the Sea Demon missile, and we naturally acceded to that request.
Where is that frigate now, Minister?
It's no longer in service with the Royal Navy. It's been decommissioned.
It's been sunk.
It was used in tests to demonstrate the effectiveness of the Sea Demon missile. That's all I'm prepared to say.
It wasn't, of course, intended to be the target in those tests, was it? In fact, it was the ship from which the missile was launched. Unfortunately, the missile went straight through the bottom of the ship, didn't it, Minister? A ship worth £170 million.
You would not expect me to comment on the outcome of secret missile tests.
Well, then, perhaps you could tell me why immediately afterwards the Ministry of Defence compulsorily purchased an area of the seabed off the coast of Wales.
No, I'm afraid I can't. It is not our policy to comment on the roles of our various defence establishments, whether they be on land or under the water.
Are you calling HMS Bracknell an underwater defence establishment?
No, I'm not calling it anything at all. HMS Bracknell no longer falls within my responsibility.
In fact, it fell out of it, didn't it, Minister?
Have we finished?